Hi, so we made a couple of pull requests to DickMaker project yesterday, actually in the night, and today morning Kailash merged them into the project. So it made one change which fixes the header of a response. And we had added the documentation about how to get started. So these two changes are now in the project. We'll try to get some more into the project today. So I'm just going to open. It on my computer. What branch am I on? Master. I merged all my changes, so you can see that it's already been merged, and I have a config toml and DickMaker. So the DickMaker file. In the previous video, we saw how to make it. We just run make and it will build. So that's it. Today what we'll do is we'll think about the. Let me turn off the screen. So we'll think about the actual project. We need CRUD handlers and SQL operations to the Go app to add, remove, delete, approve, reject, right? So people will be submitting words, and even if it's not public submissions, the administrator can submit or add a word or edit a word. So we need that, adding and editing, and we need removing. Okay, these are all for public submissions, and so CRUD handlers directly links to the register handlers function, which this we looked at yesterday. So let's think about this. There is already. Okay, I'd rather open the same local init.go. There already is a few. There already is this, and what we will need is something where people can add. Edit and all that. So let's first look at the schema. This is how entries are now. There is ID, GUID, ID is a serial family key automatically generated, possibly. GUID, possibly not. Content is the word, I suppose. Weight is okay, these have a default value. Now let's check the sample dictionary and see how. So okay, there's an MD5 of the word lang content initial TS vector. What's response? Okay, so insert Italian definitions for Apple. There are no vectors here, and there are no tokens. So this GUID column is going to be a problem. So we need to figure out how Kailash is inserting data at the moment. Now, is there a script? Is there a script? Is there something which Kailash uses for load languages? No. All requests that is loaded. How does let's look at Knuth's deposit this and see this is like a alert. Maybe alert has alert is not here. Alert, I don't think. As a script, alert in script. No. When is in script which inserts that the two. Came upon Fennington connection generates meeting has other functions produces question here. That is a word you must have been produce same pointing hash, thus making them indexable in such a way. I guess sound and not. Spelling, that's great. Now alert dictionary is there, alert open data is there, dict maker is there, but how does dict maker ka upload work, or how do you put data? Concepts are there. Dictionary, query, sample, fields. Okay, so there are two ways to go right now. One, we could ask Kailash, or another is we could decide on ourselves what kind of a strategy we can use. So question is, why do we need a GUID here? A custom unique GUID for every entry. Unique GUID for every entry. So how do you get a unique GUID, and why does it matter, and how do you make sure that it is unique? And are we using it anywhere else? Entries, UID, UID, queries, we are using that, but where else do we use? Entries, table, schema. Okay, so all of this we have to update it. From search using GUID. Maybe search is not using GUID, but see, this is a problem, right? Apple has, if there's already the word Apple, we would need to insert another unique ID. So it will have to be something like Apple one. Now, how do we get a number one every time? Or two or three? We'll have to go and search if there's already that. So I would assume that makes the entire operation slow. And it's already MD5, so we won't even know if let's do one thing, let's create an issue. How to generate GUIDs, or need a strategy to generate GUIDs for entries. The sample SQL uses GUID like MD5 of Apple one, etc. If we have a sorted list of words, we can predictably create GUIDs like this. But when a random word is being inserted, how do we generate a GUID? Related questions. One, do you have a link to a script you use for inserting data into a lab? Two is GUID What's the purpose of VR? Let's look at LR and see if GLE used anywhere. Yes, do. Oh, this is a Kannada dictionary, yeah? The Kannada English dictionary, yeah? Okay. So, using glossary, maybe it's using glossary. Who knows? Anyhow, when a random word is being inserted, how do we generate? Let me add some more context to this question. So, either we have to count one option is to make a fixed strategy for generating GUID, something like this. Let new word is equal to apple. Let existing count equal to count, and this is all pseudocode. Pseudocode. From entries where word is equal to apple. Let new count is equal to existing count. That's one. Let GUID is equal to NB. GUID key is equal to new word. Dollar new count. What language is this? Okay, what language this is? Let GUID is equal to MD5 GUID key. Another option is to drop the GUID column if it is not important, or it can be generated from the other column. Let Kailash reply to that. So meanwhile, we'll worry about the rest of the rest of the thing. So now we need this. This we can get. Tokens. Now, where do we get tokens from? these Panora tokenizer will generate TSM tokens. This will generate tokens. See where this is used. Canada is not used on it. Build tokenizers. Build tokenizer. But where is it used? Probably used in the script. With Kailash users. Okay. I wish there was a way to pause recording in this menu entry. And I want to download OBS source code and I'll pull the question. But we could do that. But no need to react shape. Okay, so where are we now? Let's do one thing, let's not worry about the existing fields. Let's only worry about how we would add something for English. Okay, so this is the scheme. Let it be as it is. We will need to create a query for inserting, right? Yeah. Direct manage and token manage. Let's do this. Let's name insert word. Which branch are we? Git checkout. Add word. Select count star over star entries. Okay. Select sharpen direct match union node. Select sharpen token match order by time box it. So the direct string match first 50 cards of the query or see if there are matches for simple nailing removes English tokens. Tokens rank is inverted string length that all results in this query have a negative rank. There is smaller numbers represent shorter string. First strings are considered closing match. Count star over incident with Q as built-in post-prediction tokenizer.
H1.2, then black note is query little. Okay, this is a very complicated SQL, I guess. Span from the tree square, select count star over as tuple, comma, entries dot star. So it will select everything in entries, comma, minus one blah blah as rank from entries where dollar 4 is equal to empty or language equal to dollar 4, which means if dollar 4 is given, that language will be used. And cardinality text 0 or types, okay, so. Okay, so that's doing the matching, right? We need to do only an insert. So insert into entries. What can we insert? We can insert what do we need to insert? Let's say sample.sql. GID lang and content we need to insert. So GID lang content. But what about the meaning? One second. Apple, English, Apple, A. That's the pronunciation. And what is this? This is the definition. Now, this is a relation. Same. What one apple, two, three, and two, five, and the weight. Okay. So we'll need three things. We probably need a transaction also here. Okay, this is not straightforward because we also need, what if there's an existing definition, right? There's an existing definition, we need to know the relation. So should the DB do all of this matching or should the application do all of this matching? Okay, now that's complicated. Insert into entries UID lang content initial tokens form. Let's say there is already Apple and three definitions. Now how does someone add a definition? They would say add a definition and they would already know, they would have to select which word they're adding it to, and they would have to select which word they're adding it to. And add one, right? So insert into entries need not always happen. Although it can happen. Now how will the DB know? We need an upsert here. Does Postgres have an upsert?
Postgres may not have an upsert. Insert into entries GID lang content. Values. $1, $2, $3. On conflict. In conflict. On conflict of content or GUID. Wait, conflict conflict can occur. Okay. Let's say on conflict GUID. Okay, I was just telling Kailash to remove GUID. Now I am going to use UID. It's not nice. Can on conflict take two values and see if there's a conflict? Is there a unique constraint? Drop. Index, create index. There is no unique constraint. So we'll have to make it handle a conflict. Let's just do this now. On conflict. Do update. Maybe. Okay. Let's see how this works. So that is there. Now what do we need? We need to run this query. We need the application to do this somewhere. So do search is what does search. And this is an api.go. Let's do this. Let's copy this function and change it to large of function, but nevertheless. And let's create a new function called add word. New word definitions from it and adds it to DB and returns results. Function add word. Okay, now is the time to learn Go. So what on earth is the second Golang function definition? A function can take 0 more arguments. In this example, I take 2 types this thing. Unless the type comes after the variable name. So here AddWord is taking R, which is an HTTP request, coreference, and app, which is an app. Now, what is this? That's probably the return, and return as a tuple, probably. Right, let's see how to search. Yeah, so it's returning 3 things. Now okay, this is not relevant for adding a word, but okay, let's do one thing. From lang is a problem. Imagine this situation. Someone comes across a word in English. They don't know the meaning, so they add it. They can do that, right? They can add just the word. So it is possible to add a so let's make this just lang. And let's say word is equal to this one format like this g dot okay. Why does it say word? Okay, word is not used because word is not used. QPPG are not useful. QR URL query on escape. So I worry about these trimming and all of that now. This is not required. Now this has to be defined. And I suppose add dot go will look just like search dot go. Except doesn't need tokenizer, maybe it does. Tokenizer represents a function that takes a string and returns this. This is like a interface. So this is an interface. Queries can be prepared to be queries. So this has to be add word star SQLX statement query add word. Don't need this. Search represents the dictionary search interface. Okay, let's make this not add, but this should be manage. And this would be manage.com. Type manage. Don't need this. It's a script type add word from lang string and content or word. I suppose Go will automatically, yeah, so when I save it automatically does this. That's where this comes. don't know why this comment is required, but nonetheless. Entry represents a dictionary entry. We don't need it for now. New search returns an instance of the search interface. Why do we need a search interface? New search and search queries queue. This is create one. New add. New manager turns an instance of the manager. Fung new manager queue. This is not Kotlin. Star. Manage. Return and manage queries queue. Okay, find entries returns. That's not, I think that's not required. Although I think that's where the actual search happens, so we will need this. We will copy it from the other file. So okay, now what do we need? That's there. We need copy this and call it do add. That's a word, I suppose. M would be manager. Manage. Do add. Q is a query. Which query? Q is not a query. Q should be W. And the return value would be firstly, what is this part of Golang type before function name? Okay, it means that reset is a method on start policy. This is very basic. Go, you really need to start with the go to. So this is essentially going to make manage to add. So let's just call it add. Let's take a tour later. Entries, just make it return a boolean. If it was added, we'll say yes. If it's not added, say no. Okay, if there is a tokenizer, It will use that tokenizer. Now, what does it know where to use a tokenizer from? From config. We need to add this, but we'll just skip it for now. Our output be a boolean. Now this would be if our m dot queries dot adverb dot select. So this is especially on corner and see. Okay, let's go to search. SQLX statement select. I need a way to insert using that. Select query execute. SQLX is a library for extensions to database underlying database untouched. Insert. Insert would be a must execute, I guess. SQLX insert prepared statement. So signal is a go. Go. Okay, so execute. Let's make it dot exec and out. Okay, it can't do and out. Maybe it can. Let's see. What does exec return? So it doesn't have return anything, right?
Okay, let's just do this. W dot mlang dot word. We also need a GUID. Where on earth could we get a GUID in an MD5? Okay, let's just do this for now. Let's take the query and say MD5 of dollar. Let's see how that goes. So we have that and that. Okay. This is can I initialize one variable with two L? Okay, so exec How does EXEC and what is that? So let's go to Golang SQL EXEC. EXEC executes a query without returning any rows. The args are for any place on the parameter in the query. Okay, so let's just do this. Let's remove this handout. And now what? What? Any exec anywhere? Except what I execute. If underscore icon app db exec string. Underscore red. String Q. So why can't SQLX? SQLX named Okay, this is what I want. Connect. Okay. Search.go. Is able to do that with select. What we need is exes or must exes. Select takes what? Select takes a query and REST interface. Okay, we need something like this, right? Query and query exes. Named yes. Query is not. Get will do a query. Okay. What if we do insert on a query? Why does insert need SQLX insert? So the thing is, I don't need to worry about the return value. very So if I directly write down the SQL command here, there's a way to make this work. But what I am thinking is, can I make this work with this SQLX statement insert? That's what I need. SQLX statement with the insert. Or can I, what is the thing with the HTMT? Type DB, type HTMT. Okay, this is on it. HTMT can do select can also do still must execute. That should work. Yeah, see now we're not worried about tokenizer now. Oh, where did I do a yeah now what fair not equal to nil. Fair not equal to nil. Return false 0 error. Cannot use error. Oh, this. No. What does must exit return? SQL result. What does select return? Error. So how do I know? If must, oh okay, must exec will panic. Me think about this for a second. Must exec will panic and Okay, so what we need to do is catch the panic. Go is not Python, you should properly check. No, that's what. So go probably doesn't. Let's check the SQL statement. Ha. So let's do this. Save result address equal to see if we're not equal to nil, return that, else return true, and 1 minute. Not declare but not used. Fine. Okay. That's just our. Issue there. Now next what? Out is equal to and do we need a out is false. Start with that. If underscore okay, that's fine. Now this would be query equals read search comp. So this will be search manage. Search confirming in where did search come from? CW and that. Okay, so we need here is github.com. Okay, this one work right. So the relative book. I do this. Let's see if it'll work. Didn't work really. And no. Didn't work. Go use a relative path. Input. But how is it supposed to work? Okay, so how do I go import while development? Okay. This is a problem. So internal is already in this, but then API uses github.com import. Now I'm updating internal. Now if I'm updating internal, go imports. This is what I need. Can you do a go get would place all the source content? See full repo in case of Laura's and the because. Okay, so for now we'll do this, I suppose, and then is that not how it works? Can I do a do the start of slash? What is to Golang import. This is Golang dot not go, but anyhow import alias import the dot import. Nested imports. That's general Golang. Cheated. first create directory for the package named home hello mustangs and then a file named reverse.go directory for the components. Now home hello mustangs go build. Okay, so internal manage probably already has a package name, which should be manage. I'm so not good. Next thing we need is put that there. That seems to work. Let us see if this works now. Aha, that's all we need to do. We just have to change the package. Fine, so next what? Query is equal to manage dot add word from lang word. Yeah. I don't just add it then. Out is not to be passed. Okay. Now what? Can I just pass a bool? I don't need that. Where does app get a search from? Oho. Manage. Star manage. Select. Define next what? Okay, so
Return false. Need relations. And that I'll just return true. It's out. I just need one this true and rest. And we stop. Yep, that's it. Don't need the out. So by now you should have realized this is not a serious thing. I'm still running code, so now what? Now we have fun handle such. We need a func handle add. It was the same. Whatever it was saying. Handle add should do. Add. Coolant error. Status and error. It is okay, Risp. Something like that, okay. Let's say status. It's fine. This is unused. It's unused. Because it's unused. Let's see. Unused. Everything will be used now. So next thing we need to do is we need to add this to the handle. Somewhere we need to handle it, right? So r dot get. Okay, we shouldn't use get for a insert operation, but let's not worry about that now. Word app. Yeah. Now, what does anyone say? Let's try a make. And so I'll open SQL. So this is the DigMaker database, and you can see entries has these many things, 12 rows, Apple, blah 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 blah. So we need to do run dict maker, not in this here. Yeah, now I can do localhost slash API. Yeah, that works. Now next thing we can do is, what did I add it as? Okay, shouldn't have added a text. Manage. Okay, so I'm gonna say manage English, and I need a new word. Let's say orange, unknown from language. Why is English unknown? From lang, get made it lang. Thank you. Connection was reset. Fantastic. So there's been some great. Okay, error, fine. So this probably needs to be initialized. Main.go manage yeah. This where manage queue is equal to manage. benchmark. Right. Oh, this needs to be done. So go SQLX dot scan to strat and manage Q. Okay, so anyhow, it's being scanned there. Can I directly pass that here? No, the structure is different. Oh, so bad, so bad. Let's do one thing. Let's see if there's a way to okay, so this is a custom. Some kind of deflection uses. I think. A better way to do this would be. Let's do this. Let's for now, just to make this work, take that. Take that and put it in. Manage.go. In how do I get an SQLX statement? How do I create an SQLX statement? Need to create a statement, right? Let's see how want to start this out. Prepared query is equal to, okay, so you need to do db dot prepare x and that query. That's all right, so you just need to do here in manage.go do I get to prepare db from. Okay, how did crash the DB? Someone passes a DB down. Do I have a DB somewhere? App. Does app have a DB? Yeah, app has a DB. So okay, let's do this the easy way. Let's just do main manage that after manage is called manager new manager. New manager will take nothing and return manage with the query like so let this be a string. Okay. And a string like that. So how do I create? Go create struct. Type queries. Add word. Okay. Hear that? Now you'll have to get access to the DB here. Let me take a small break. Okay, so I'm back now. What did I? Yeah, so we are not going to use a prepared statement here. We are going to okay, ideally we need to use a prepared statement, but we need to do a lot of things for that, so we'll just do this now. We'll take a we will take a DB instance also. DB. Should we use a DB here? Let's just use a DB here and worry about skillex.db. Worry about how to take care of that later. This would be dot query handler dot exec would become db.exec and db dot okay go to SQL db.exec next up query would be that. Yeah, let's see how it works now. Oh wait, we have to change how it's called. Add will take app.db also. Oh, it. Yeah, let's try doing that. Make and that, and then localhost 8080 API. English, orange. 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 Okay. Is now at least trying to insert it to the DB, although that's an error. Syntax error return here. Okay, that's a very good error because means everything else worked. Insert into entries values on conflict to update. Syntax error at turn here. Sit on conflict, that's a problem. On conflict. Queries. Should there be no on conflict to update.
That should be fine, right? Let's see, illustrative guide. Insert. Okay, this one doesn't use any semicolons. Let's remove the semicolon. Make syntax error at end of input. Syntax error at end of input. Let's try running this. Try running this as yeah, insert into entries values identify test. This would be English. This will be test. Should have a dollar two and update. Didn't work. Well, if I don't give on conflict, it did work. Postgres insert. An example with on. Oh, okay. And conflict requires a treatment. So let's not do this. Or let's on conflict to let's do on conflict do nothing. Okay. And make now. Okay, that exceeded. Now can I see an orange in select star from entries? There should be 14 entries. Yep, and there's an orange. That's lovely. Okay, so for now we'll just end this, but we have looked at SQL, like SQL, and passed some things around. Now if that, so what we need to do now is we need to ask Kailash what strategy to follow to need a way to expand have to organize new code right now. Queries.sql
solve the SQL queries. These are used to prepare statements in search.go. But search.go doesn't seem to be the right place to add new features related to admin add word add update delete approve words. So if we create a manage.co, there's a problem that we cannot not we cannot there's a problem that if we create a manage.co, there's a problem that to initialize the queries we cache it search.go initialize. How do you propose that the queries be organized for new functionalities? Okay, let's just see what Coca-Cola says for that. Now that's done, we just end this for the moment. Bye bye.